There is no one like you. Alpha and Omega. Oh, there is no one like you.
Hallelujah.
Gamma and keeping us.
Father, we bless you, we thank you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Amen.
No, amen. There's no prayer, that one now. There's no prayer there. Happy Valentine's Day. Happy Valentine's Day. Are you also wishing me a Valentine's Day?
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can you wish an old woman like me or 50 years of a Valentine's? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God bless you. You can have your seats in the presence of God. Today is the another day. Today is your day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today is your day. Take it, today is your day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I just want to go straight to the word of God. I'm so excited. And I thank God for his mercy and for his love, his unconditional love. The love of God is more than the love that we have for each other in the world today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, I love you. But God loves you the more. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, I love you 50%. God loves you more than all the persons that you know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, people must know that we don't love each other 100%. There's nothing like that. Hallelujah. Even in the marriage, there's no love 100%. Okay, who wants to die for me now if you love me? Nobody.
Asili ara kufira ngenye se wa harange. Wato.
But Jesus died for us.
Jesus kwatufira.
So the love of God is more than that we love ourselves. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, I love you. But Jesus loves you the most. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Tell your neighbor. Don't misbehave because I tell you I love you. I love you, but don't misbehave. So this morning, let us go quickly in the book of Luke chapter 18. Book of Luke chapter 18, from 37. And then I will stop somewhere. Ms. Kadiva, you can read until
42. Firange nkenda abapitire komeo tamkaba asi amwene nye ageta zigire konye unene asi mnonda fita firange nkenda makura Yesus taskama tanike asi vamumuretere gwina eiga heda pepi Yesus tampura asi ei ono hara nani kurugane na inke ageta limburura asi homba ningange nimonehena Yesus tam tandere asi mona epuro loge linakparura. Amen.
Verse 37. So they told him that Jesus of Nazareth was passing by. Say passing by.
Passing by.
Say passing by.
Passing by.
Say louder, passing by.
Passing by.
So they told him that Jesus of Nazareth was passing by. And he cried out. Say, cried out.
Cried out.
Everybody, please repeat after me, even if you are a pastor. Cried out.
Cried out.
Cried out.
Cried out.
Make sure that your neighbor is obedient. Please repeat after me. Cried out.
Cried out.
And he said, and he cried out, saying, Jesus, son of David. Say, Jesus, son of David.
Jesus, son of David.
Do it again. Jesus, son of David.
Jesus, son of David.
Have mercy on me.
Have mercy on me.
Then those who went before warned him that he should be quiet. Say, quiet.
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 Today, every noise in your life, every voice that is making noise in your life will be quiet in the name of Jesus. Every disturbance in your life, we silence them today in Jesus' name. Then those who went before warned him that he should be quiet. But he cried out all more, son of David, have mercy on me. So Jesus stood still, says stood still. And commanded him to be thrown to him. So Jesus stood still and commanded him to be brought to him. And when he had come near, he asked him, saying, what do you want me to do for you? He said, Lord, that I may receive my sight. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I want us to read quickly the same but from verse 38 to 39. And he cried out, saying, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. Then those who went before warned him that he should be quiet. Hallelujah. Today I have titled my message, unnecessary roadblocks in your way. Unnecessary roadblocks in your way, in your journey to your victory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Unnecessary roadblocks. Unnecessary traffics in your way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Appreciate the topic. Appreciate the topic. Something is about to happen in your life today. Anything that is unnecessary, that is standing in your way, today it will give a way for you to move on. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the Bible says in verse 37, so they told him that Jesus of Nazareth was passing. Jesus of Nazareth was passing, going to another city. So they told this person that Jesus is passing. It was kind of like a gossip.
Or
it was kind of like a story they were telling each other. Say, Jesus is passing today. Jesus is on the journey. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know what the people are talking about. When you are going on your journey to your breakthrough, when you are planning, hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know what the people are telling each other. When you are planning your marriage, I don't know what, who is this person that is carrying your program to tell other person. So this man was told, Jesus of Nazareth is passing. He's having the journey to go. He's about to go and heal somebody that side. He's about to go and bless somebody that side. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say everybody that is monitoring you today, everybody that is monitoring your business today, everybody that is monitoring your plans today, catch fire! Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are people that you don't see. There are people that you don't know. But there are people that is monitoring your life. There are people that is monitoring your plans. Anything that you want to do, they know. Anything that you want to plan, they know. There are people that carry the anointing of destroying the plans of other people. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those people, you don't send them to carry your message. But they are secret message carrier. You did not employ them to do that. But these people are used by the devil to carry your history around. Today, by the power of God, invested in the name of Jesus, we blind everybody that monitors you. Can you stand up and receive? Hallelujah!
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
We destroy the eyes of those that monitor you. Anything that you want to do, they want to monitor unnecessary, and they want to put unnecessary roadblocks in your way. Before you plan, you knew that the road was clear. Before you plan, you knew that everything was fine. But there are certain people in your life that is finding out your information, and then they are putting the roadblocks. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Today, by the power of Jesus, we blind every enemy of yours. Every enemy that is following you, they are putting roadblocks in your way so that you can make an accident. They want you not to succeed. They want you not to have a successful journey. They don't want you to end up with a good testimony. And they are planning things in the way. They are planning things in your way. But before you take off your journey, you plan very well that I'm going to buy that car. You plan very well that I'm going to start that business. You plan very well. You did all that you can do.
But there are people that is following you. Before you do your plan, they are going before you. And they are doing the same thing. But today, if you stand up, receive with me. In the mighty name of Jesus, I blind everybody that is following you spiritually. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Are we together?
Amen.
So they told him. They told him. People are talking about you. If they can talk about Jesus.
He
said, oh, we saw. They bought a new car. We saw. They are making the bricks. We saw. They want to send their kids to university. There are people that is monitoring your family. But because of you to be a member of Faith Bible Church, today fire will reach everybody that is putting blocks in your way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And this guy, when he was told that Jesus is passing, he decided, yes, I have a problem, but I don't care about the problem of Jesus. Jesus was having his own program. He was just passing, going somewhere to do his assignment. And all of us, we know Jesus was called to heal people, to do signs and wonders. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus was not going around doing nothing. But the Bible says Jesus was anointed, going around doing good, healing people, and those that is oppressed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So these people wanted to step the program of God. They wanted to step the calling of God. They wanted to step the ministry of God. So every place where Jesus was going, they were telling each other, are you listening to me? They were giving each other information. He is coming to Jericho.
He
is coming to Jerusalem. He's coming to wedding. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's passing. He's passing. He's coming. He's coming.
Is
coming. Even if it was not time for Jesus, they wanted Jesus to do a miracle. One day the family of Jesus was invited to a wedding in Cana. Can you hear me there? Can you hear me there? Hallelujah. Can you hear me, people in the third floor? Soon I'm going to ask the people in on top, some of them that will sit there. I don't know. Soon and very soon I will go and ask the people that will sit on top of you. We are marching by faith. We are marching by faith. We don't see people sitting there, but we are talking to people sitting there. I see a group of people sitting there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
One day Jesus was invited to Canaan. And he went to the wedding. And when he reached there, apparently the wine got finished. Say after me, finish.
Finish.
Finito.
Finito.
Tuako ah.
Tuako ah.
Tuako ah.
Tuako ah.
So the wine got finished. And it was not time for Jesus to do the miracle. But there were certain people that was monitoring that Jesus is coming. And then they told Mary the mother, the wine is finished. Tell your son to do something. And the son answered the mother. And he said, it's not my time to do the miracle. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know what is that one that the people are forcing you to do that you did not plan to do. You have your own time, you have your own vision. But they are putting the roadblocks in your way for you to lose your direction and for you to do the things you did not plan to do. Are you listening to me? Are you listening to me? And then the Bible says, he cried out. You know, a person that cried out make a noise. A person that cried out loud make a noise. I have never seen a man. Have you seen your husbands when they cry out loud? I have not seen one. Amen. Amen.
Mugara.
Wives, I'm talking to you. I'm asking you. You have not seen, eh? Yeah, I have not seen.
Asika paimona?
These 20 years, I have not seen.
Asimono vula na murongo mbali etika paimona wo.
Sometimes I will just see the tears coming and ask, what is wrong?
Pame kumona tupo mahote gakwata ulipura singi ya lirimbi.
You understand what I'm saying? But this man cried out loud. He cried out loud. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He cried out loud. He was disturbing the journey of Jesus. He was disturbing the journey of Jesus. Every noise in your way. Every noise that make that noise. Every voice that is disturbing you to lose your focus today in the name of Jesus. I command that noise to be silenced. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I command that noise to be silenced. Quickly. Let's go to Matthew chapter 21. Matthew chapter 21 verse 18. Ms. Kativa, you can read.
Mateus agano mrongo mbali na zime virisi mrongo na ntanta tu. Eikwasa Yesus makura tatengwire kostata tazuvunzara. Amen.
Say it again.
Eikwasa Yesus makura tatengwire kostata makura tazuvunzara.
Is okay. Continue.
Makura tamono ukuzu konzira. Tau hedere nye kugwanako nye ihako yelike. Tau tandere asi, narumwe sihena ngamtunda moge iima, naruwalisi ukuzu nare unakukuta.
Okay, Matthew chapter 21, verse 18. Okay, let us just read from verse 17, so that we can understand well. I say, I'm talking today about unnecessary roadblocks in your way, in your journey.
Sikuwa kuyunga kuhame nasi ilimbi kisa yokupira hepe romonzira zoge. Sato wale kerebezo mrongu ntambali.
Then he left them and went out of the city to Bethany. Then he left them. This is Jesus.
Ogu Yesu sa?
He left them.
Yugawa sigire.
And he went out of the city to Bethany. So it means he was going, he was again on the journey going.
Asiapa hena kwa kere monzira ke kunakuza.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He was going, he was on his journey.
Kwa kere monzira zendi zokuza.
Verse 18. Now in the morning as he returned to the city, he was hungry. And seeing a fig tree by the road, he came to eat and found nothing on it but leaves. Nothing, he found nothing. But he saw a fig tree. But when he came nearby, he saw nothing. Say nothing.
Nothing.
Repeat after me, nothing.
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 He saw nothing on it, but only leaves. And he said to it, let no fruit grow on you ever again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let no fruit grow on you ever again.
Amen.
Let no fruit grow on you ever again.
Asitupu iimanga iimako henande nyango.
Everybody look at me now.
Kegume tareni konane.
Jesus was again on the journey going.
Yesus kwakere simbe monzira zorugendo rokuza.
Every time Jesus is on the journey, if it is not a people, then it is a tree.
Asi kenya pakara yesa monzira seka pia kwaneke yana wantu usichi.
If it is not Lazarus family, then it is, what is that guy who went on top of the tree?
Zacchaeus.
Is
Zacchaeus.
So this time around, Jesus was going.
Jesus kwa genda
on the journey.
Monzira zendi.
He was going on the journey.
Age kuna genda monzira zendi.
And on the journey he saw a tree.
Monzira zendi tamonoschi.
And he was admiring to go to the tree and eat something.
Age kwa gazare yasi akagwaneko nyango koschi.
But when he reached at the tree,
apakaka sikire koschi.
He realized.
Yoga dimbirasi.
That this tree is not having any fruits.
Eschi kutupwe nyango liakarako.
But this tree is not having any food.
Asi es stick up sakara ne nyango.
But it's only leaves.
Kwakara ko tupi hako yelike.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know.
Captain Diva,
which type of the tree is growing on your journey to your marriage?
Assist him singe sakumena monzira zonongwara doge.
I don't know.
Captain Diva,
which type of the tree have grown in your education, in your finances?
Assist him singe samena melirongolo gendi moimaliwa yoge.
Jesus have power to dig out that tree and throw away.
Yesus gakara nonkondo dokus duramoso stias zugume.
But he did not want to waste any time.
Yakap gakeno siruoso kuhepeka.
By digging the tree and the roots out.
Mokus duramoschi nonondana.
Look at me.
Daren konane.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look at me.
Daren konane.
So Jesus decided.
Yesus yokato kwere.
To curse the tree.
Afingeschi.
A tree is a big thing.
Chis ningeso snene.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's not easy.
Kapisure.
To dig out the tree when you are alone. It needs your energy, it needs your power. But Jesus used his mouth and then he cast the tree. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are some people that is heavy like a tree in your journey. Are you listening to me? You are doing whatever you do, but they don't want to move. Am I talking to Faith Bible Church Kurenguru?
Amen.
Am I talking to Faith Bible Church Kurenguru?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know who is that one. Behaving like a fig tree in your way. Behaving like somebody that will, you know, fig tree, God thought that he will get help there. God thought he will be helped there and get food to eat. But the fig tree did not help him. There are people in your way to your victory. They look like they will help you. They pretend like they will help you. Am I talking to somebody?
Amen.
They talk like they will help you. They talk like they will bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But they are actually there to frustrate you. They are there to frustrate your calling. They are there to frustrate your marriage. Am I talking to somebody here?
Amen.
You rely on them. You rely on them for help. When you see them, you are excited that I will receive help. When you see them, you are happy. This brother will help them. But they are there for your frustration. Jesus came close to the fig tree. And as he was coming close, he was seeing his help. But when he came closer, he realized that this fig tree is having nothing but the leaves. Bible says we will be known by our fruits. We will not be known by our leaves, but by our fruits. Everybody that does not bear fruit from your life today. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let them volunteer to live. Let them volunteer to live. Let them volunteer to live. I say, let them volunteer to live. Out of your life. Out of your life. In the name of Jesus. 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 I say, in the name of Jesus. I'm standing, you are sitting. I say, in the name of Jesus. I'm talking to those people that are standing in the name of Jesus. I'm talking to those people that is appreciating everybody in your life.
Look,
they look like they are there to help. They look like they are there to help you. To put something in your stomach. They look like they are there to help you. To reach your destiny. But they are there to destroy you. Today by the power. In the name of Jesus. I command them to live from your life. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Every noise. As you are planning your marriage. As you are planning your business. As you are planning to go for the next level. Every noise. Shouting in your way. You know how people say, you will not make it. You want to apply to be a principal? Oh, you want to apply to be
an HOD?
It's too much of work. You will not make it. Sister, you want to get married? You want to get married? I'm telling you, all the men, they are not good. And this person that is encouraging you like that, she is also married. She is also a married woman. And you are telling her, Mama, I'm planning to get married. And she's telling you that is the last thing that you can do on your own way. Everybody that makes noise in your way today, in the mighty name of Jesus, everybody that makes noise in your life today, by the fire of God, I cast them out in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Matthew 20. Matthew 20. You can have your seats. Matthew 20. Are you learning something? Are you learning something? Matthew 20, verse 29.
Oh.
Matthew 20, verse 29.
Apa watundire mweliko emumbunga lenene lya kweme Yesus.
How many people?
Jesus.
How many?
Wangapi?
A lot, eh?
So wanzi.
Okay, let's read. Now, as they went out of Jericho, a great multitude followed him. And behold, two blind men sitting by the road, when they heard that Jesus, hey, this was a hearing story, eh? When they heard that Jesus was passing by, they cried out again.
Okay,
let us read from verse 28, Meskadiva, until 31.
Tatuareke pono mrongo mbali na ntanta tutoko no mrongo tatu na zimwe na mnomtu na gesi kapiga wizira asi wayam kerere age kwa wizira aya kerere agawe aya gawe mwenye gwendi gukare zoe so wantu mrongo mbali na ntane apa watu ndire mweriko embunga lenene lya kweme Yesus watareko watiku wabali baba awo hawa nazi mkuingira ponzira. Makura tawazu asi Yesus anakupita po, tawazigira asi. Homba mnanda fita tufirankenda. Mbunga makura tawazu wakawa asi wa mweneko. Nyewena tawaziguru kakuzigira asi. Homba mnanda fita tufirankenda. Amen.
Verse 28. Just as the Son of Man did not come to be saved, but to save and to give his life a ransom for many. Now, as they went out of Jericho, a great multitude followed him. Just as he went out, he was again on the journey. Jesus was not stopped by the last noise of yesterday. Today he was going again. He was not stopped by the noise that people made last week, but he was still, every morning he was on journey. Am I talking to somebody?
Amen.
He was not stopped by the noise of last year. And he did not say, God, I cannot do the ministry. These people, every time I want to go and preach, they are disturbing me. He did not stop. Nothing separates Jesus from his calling. But every time he was planning to go to next city, there was something that was disturbing him. But he did not give up. He will sleep and go early in the morning. Recently we were saying it was a fig tree. That it was on his way. And he was hungry, he wanted to eat something. But it did not disturb him. Now we are hearing again. He's planning the journey to go to Jericho. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus was having the spirit of never give up.
Yesus kwa kere no mpepo zo kupira kuligawa.
He was never late. They receive when they give.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I saw three people were sleeping in this first church, is why I'm singing. You like singing than to preach. So when I preach, you are sleeping. Is that church ready? Or is there somebody sleeping there? Are you ready? Are you ready? This time around, he planned to go to Jericho. People of God, let me encourage you. You are unstoppable. When the devil closed this door, there is another door ready for you. Hallelujah!
Amen.
You are unstoppable. You don't work with water. You don't work with electricity. You don't work with batteries. You work with the power from heaven. Nothing can stop you. Nothing can stop you. You have the mind of God in you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They try today here. In the night, God gives you a creativity. When you wake up next morning, you explore. Hallelujah. Are you listening to me? Are you listening to me? In this world, we will have tribulation, Jesus
says.
We will have disappointments. We will have suffering. We will be sick. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But you never give up. You never give up. You come to a door that you are used. And you look at the door. You try to open the door. You put the key. And the key is struggling. And the key is struggling. I need your support. And the key is struggling. And then you look to the door. And you look to the door. And say so. I know only person that can close the door in my life. It might be the devil. But if God closed the door, I know he has prepared the next door. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Amen.
There's no door of a child of God.
Amen.
That can be closed. And be closed forever. You are supernatural. You are impossible. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When they say we are finished with them. When they say we are finished with that family. God have just started with you. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
When they laugh at you and say it's over. It's over. In the program of God. In the diary of God. You a number. That it is your time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? I don't know who have given up on his own life. I don't know who have given up over his own life. Over your own marriage. Over your own business. I don't know with whom I'm speaking. I don't know with whom I'm speaking. But you look at yourself and you say, I have given up. And God says, it was not your time. You were doing it out of your power. You were using your energy. You were using your power. Everybody that says today, I'm tired. God was not in it. I'm tired. I have tried my best. Can you understand the English you are speaking? You say, I have tried my best. I am tired.
Yeah.
Did Jesus say he's tired?
Yes, I go get another rock and
did Jesus say he's tired of your problem?
Yes, I go get another rock and
did he say he's tired to help you?
I say aroroka moku kwa fandi.
Aya, I'm tired.
Naroroka.
One day I spoke to my daughter after the church.
Is that what you're going to get?
She's also here. I don't know where we were hanging. I don't know. Sometimes this church is going out very early. This 2 hours. 2 hours is too much early. So that Sunday the service went out.
I
think it's 2 Sundays ago. So I was hanging around looking for attention.
Look,
every baby person carrying his Bible.
Going.
So I saw a car was parked under the tree. From here I walked there looking for attention. When I went there, she told me, Mama, I wanted to call you later. And she showed me a picture of her daughter's feet. And she told me the doctor said they are tired. They said the doctor said they are tired of giving her medication. And they know what they could do for that type of infection or allergic, but now they are tired. They invite us, they told us to go to Windhoek for specialists. Are you listening to me? And she saw me the photo of the daughter's feet. And when I look at it, somebody told me here, your prayer cannot make it
though.
You must refer this one to somebody else. And then I look around, no pastor. All the pastors they went back. And I lay my hands. I'm talking to that woman standing there. I'm not talking a drama. And I lay my hand on the cell phone. And I say, in the name of Jesus, this is a year of recovery. I pray that this little girl will recover her right feet. In the mighty name of Jesus. And we prayed. I thought it was the only prayer request. Am I encouraging somebody today? When you say you are tired, God has never started with you. It was your own power. It was your own wisdom that you were using. Am I talking to somebody?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You were using your energy. It's why you became tired. Then she say again, Mama, I'm I'm having a tuck shop.
Aye,
mama, there's nothing happening there. Aye, it's just a waste of time. I'm sitting there, people are not even buying bread. Mama, I want to close the tuck shop. I said, don't discourage me. I'm about to open the tuck shop and then you want to close. Don't discourage me. Mama, there's no business in tuck shop. Things can stand and expire. I say it, Father, in the name of Jesus. I pray for your tuck shop. Favor. Favor, 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 favor. I say favor. We were here in the church. And her tuck shop is located somewhere. And I started to pray. And I said, God, I'm about to open the tuck shop. But this one is discouraging me. What you are about to do in my tuck shop, start with her right now. We prayed. We say amen.
Amen.
That was unnecessary roadblocks in our way not to do what she's supposed to do. And then I left. Another day, I don't know which day was it. We were in the room. She called.
Tabela.
Is it me who called or she called? Then it was on the loudspeaker because I was busy with something. She said, Mama, God is alive. I said, tell me how alive have you been in your life? She said, Mama, this God we are saving. She was on the loudspeaker, Baba was smiling. I said, my daughter, tell me, what are you saying? She
said,
Mama, that day you prayed for me. I was really planning to pack away all the things and close the
tuck
shop. But the next day, customers are coming. Mama, customers are coming. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
I said, tell me, my daughter. He said, even the bread I stopped to sell. Those days the bread was staying for how many days? Even 2 weeks the bread. Then you stopped to sell. Come here. We are serving the gods of miracle. I know. Yes, I know. I am serving.
I'm serving the God of miracle. I know. Yes, I know.
Sorry. Some of the things are very private, sensitive. Me, I don't talk those things there. But this is to glorify the name of God. Tell me what happened.
So with your tuck shop.
People of God, the tuck shop was not moving.
Asiwana karunga mo tuck shop kwatwa tupwe ingai gendimo.
In a day, I could get $50, or if more, then it's just $80.
Asimezuanga rande sawali no dola namurongo ntano ndise yo inzi namurongo ntantatu.
I used to waste my time, my energy, my money, but nothing was coming out. At some point, I decided to just end it. So that Sunday that Mama is talking about, yes, we discussed and I told her all about it.
Like said,
Mama prayed for my child's feet. She has a type of skin disease where doctors are saying they cannot go on again. Apparently, we must seek for specialist advice. As it is, we have been searching for specialists to help us. So as Mama came my way that day in the car, She found us, I was seated with Ms.
Ndingo.
Just as usual, talking our things.
So
she went in and then we discussed, we went through and then I showed her my daughter's picture of the foot. At the moment, Mama was also scared, like, what is this? Because if you are not used to it, you'll get irritated. It's not something good. So she immediately prayed over it with power. On the phone.
Siko funguna.
So I believed right away. So we were talking about our businesses. I told her about mine that was not going well. She told me we must be thankful to God, even if it means you are getting small. At least God is providing for you. And I believed right away. I used to pray over my business and my child. So my older brother, the other time after the prayer, she called my daughter like, Nguma, how is the foot? Now she was there. He was like talking to her while she was passing. Because it's known in my family that she's having that problem. Now she just rose up her foot like that. Now the brother asked me like, what happened? What did you put on?
Asimakura hekura ndipo kampulira singe horoka. Inke oturapo.
Jesus.
I told him it's Mama that prayed for her.
Asiyo nam tanterera me onane yo wamkandererepo.
He just went like, "Oh, it's good. It's good. Prayers are working."
Asipo kawareke yakunika si awenani yawapa makandere kwa kurugana.
People of God, from that day, I have been saving money every night after my business closed. If it's less, it's a 200.
Oh!
If my kids sleep with hunger, it's because they don't want to eat.
Say it again.
If my children go with hunger in bed, it's because they don't want to eat, not because there is no food to eat.
So God have turned it around.
It's around now.
So
on top of my small salary, I'm thanking God for the business that is booming.
Hallelujah! 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 Today I want to pray with you. Doesn't matter what is a roadblock in your way. This is not how we look. This is not how we address ourselves. But this is a power of God that is in us and working through us that brings these signs and wonders in your life. Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Amen.
Maybe you are on your journey, and there is a roadblock that the devil has put. Roadblock for doubt. Many people, you are still hearing the testimony, but you are doubting. Maybe you are in your way to your journey, to your business, and you are trying whatever you can try, but the outcome that is coming out is empty. Are you hearing me this morning? You are working hard. You are investing money in your business. But end of the day, you don't make any profit. But by the power of the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, whatever you have lost, you will recover this year.
You will recover this year. Maybe as you were walking, as you were walking in your spiritual life, in your marriage, in the sickness of your children, as it testifies, and you come to a point that you say, I cannot move on anymore, and you feel discouraged. If there is a roadblock in your way for discouragement, today in the name of Jesus, I destroy that roadblock in the name of Jesus. You will never feel discouraged in your life.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's an embarrassment. To a child of God is a shame. Give me a word again. It's a disgrace to stay empty. Handed, empty wallet. I say it's a disgrace. It's a shame to the kingdom of God for you to stay dry. Every spirit behind your wallet. Every spirit behind your business. Every spirit behind your finances. Are you agreeing with me today?
Amen, Mama.
That makes you to be empty in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I destroy it today.
Amen.
Look at me quickly. Maybe on your way. Maybe on your way. You were discouraged, you were empty, you were doubting. And as you are moving, you find a roadblock. And you
are
excited. And you are excited. And the roadblock is a roadblock for gossip. Everywhere you go, they gossip you. Everywhere you go. Look at her. How is this working? The things are not working out for these people. Look at them. Everywhere you go at your work. Even they say, oh, this one is a Yefro, but he's staying with her hairstyle. She's staying with her hairstyle. For 5 weeks.
No, Iwikeitano.
Today, by the grace of God, every gossip that is following you in the name of Jesus, even in the church, the gossip can follow you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is a building built with the bricks. And Jesus don't stay in this building. But he stays in bodies of people that have accepted him. But in this building, people that he did not also accept him will come. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
So this building can be full with different spices. Maybe there is a cabana spice standing next to you. Maybe there is a chili spice standing next to you. Maybe there is a which spice do you use? Garlic standing next to you. And you know when the cabana spice gossip you, it's painful or chili. Hallelujah! Barbecue.
This is a barbecue?
That one is also dangerous. When the barbecue and barbecue spices, they are cabana spices and barbecue spices, they are too much in the kitchen of women.
So,
and then you end up in the roadblock of gossip. Just to stop you, not to continue. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
People are gossiping me. People are gossiping me. I will just stay in the house. I will not go anywhere. You don't know that when you stay in the house, they could gossip you more. I will not go to the wedding ceremony. People will gossip me. may just stay and water my flowers
every day.
Me, I will not go to the burials. People are gossiping me. Me, I will not go to the church Sunday. People are gossiping me. Every gossiper in your life, in the name of Jesus, we destroy that roadblock. Hallelujah.
Amen.
For you to have a straight way, we destroy that roadblock. And as we are moving, let us continue. As we are moving, in your way. As you are moving, we need to clear these roadblocks. If you don't deal on these roadblocks, even if you come back again, you will get them. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
You will get them. So you better deal before you continue. All these stories of Jesus we are reading here. All those people who were screaming. Jesus did not tell them, I'm on the journey, I will come back and help
you.
He was healing this one, he go. He was opening the eyes of the blind one, he go. Hallelujah, are you hearing me? Some people, they are so weak spiritually. Anything a person say, even the person was joking. The legs is already done. When are you going to be strong in your life for your own life? Me, I will not go with that way again because they are gossiping me. Me, I will take another
route.
This world, you have been stopped at the roadblocks. You don't know that when you go to Windhoek, there is roadblocks. They stop your car, they take the license, they check. I'm telling you, this is the road for to go to our farm. I don't know what Papa have done to his car, D40.
Captain, dancing kwa ruka na tata ketuwaliyo.
Police, they don't stop that car. Uncle Kavara don't stop us from tomorrow. Police, they don't stop that car.
Aso aporo si kapiwa kondele rine tuwa.
They will just say, "Moro keni tata na wandi." Ewa, bye, pastor, bye. Yeah. Ede, what is that roadblock? Roadak.
Asinampi ko roadak.
This one, Rusuf, eh? Masivi. I told Pastor John Katupuli, when you are driving D40, you are a tall person. People, they know a other size there. Please bring down the window so that they can see there's a different person.
Katupuli, asinsenyo ne makuli singa tom paturu rekende marau kwa diwa mtukwa peke gwari singeli etuwa.
Recently, one day they went December way to the farm, and then they came back, and then because they were very tall in the car, they were stopped. Papa must drive from here. True story. Papa must drive from here to Masivi. When Papa reached there, the lady said, "Oh, Pastor Mugube, okay, people go." I pray that your roadblocks will make a way for you. Hallelujah. Every roadblock of disappointment. Because one person has disappointed you, you cannot close your business.
Hey.
I try to sell fat cakes. People are just taking on my gongo. They don't bow. So I have given up. Me, I cannot do anymore. My sister,
you
cannot see that person is used by the devil to discourage you not to continue with your business.
Today,
every spirit of discouragement be cast out in the name of Jesus. Disloyalty. This one is powerful. Roadblock for disloyalty. Many of us here, we are disloyal to the ministry of God. But it does not stop God to bless us. Am I talking to somebody listening to me? Many of us, we are disloyal even to give our own tithe. Many of us, we are disloyal even just to come to the church. But God has never stopped to love us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today,
Naina,
if you are there and you carry the spirit of disloyal, today we destroy it in the name of Jesus. It will never be in your way. It will never be in your way. And as you are moving, you reach the roadblock. You reach the roadblock of fear.
So,
you know, God knew this thing before. He did not give us a spirit of fear. Do you hear me? Fear is the spirit. And if you don't remove from your roadblock, if you don't remove from your way, it will always stand in your spiritual life. Every time you want to do something, you will face that roadblock. Fear. Every time you want to do something, fear. Every time you want to go to town, fear. Every time you want to get married, fear. Every time you... Spirit of fear. Me, I told one person one day, English cannot stop me to preach. Some people say, me, I cannot greet people. I'm afraid they will laugh at me because of my English.
Hello?
No wonder we are not getting married to an Englishman because you are always... You can have your seat.
Ingireni?
I cannot speak.
I'm a Captain Vuru, Captain Vuru.
I'm afraid.
I'm a woman.
This is a spirit, fear.
In people.
Fear is a dangerous spirit. It can limit you, it can stop you to do a lot of things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Fear can give you, you will lose your destiny, you will lose you yourself, fear. One thing that I told myself, I have accepted, I have made peace with myself. Are you hearing me? I have accepted that I did not finish grade 12. I have accepted that I'm struggling, I'm learning, I'm improving my English. But it cannot stop me. How many of you don't understand what I'm saying now? Are you understanding? You don't understand what I'm saying? Yes! Spirit of fear can make you think that you think you cannot.
And you believe you cannot.
Make peace with yourself and accept. I cannot go to town because my face is full of pimples. You know, fear can bring failure. And the things that we are fearing is a thing that always happens with us. So this is a dangerous roadblock that the devil is putting in your way. I'm afraid. I cannot open the business. Sister, what? Business is not all about making money. There's also part of losing. But until you did not start, you will never know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today, every spirit of fear that you have collected yourself, I command that roadblock from your way. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I cannot make it.
I'm a Captain Ivuru.
I will not make it.
Captain Ivura.
I spoke to one lady. I said, can I invite you for the live service? Daughter, you can make it on Tuesdays. You say, unless my mom must bring the interpreter for me to speak in my vernacular language for... So that she can interpret for me.
I said,
sister, the way you are answering me, are you speaking in your vernacular? Are you speaking in English? I'm sorry to say this. People that is making today in life are the people who don't speak good English but wave. Have you seen a Chinese speaking nice English here? Have you seen one? You come here, you go and take your picture. You like it. How much? And you are changing your good English, a teacher, professional teacher. When she goes to Chinese shop, she don't speak her good English, she's changing to Chinese. Have you seen Chinese? They say, I'll go back to our country. Namibians, they just speak English. I cannot do the business. Have they say like that? Have you heard them saying and packing their bags? They are becoming full. More. With their English. And they are making money. And you are waiting for your English. To get a diploma in your English and degree. And for you to start to say, I'm selling fat cakes. I want to go and study to say I'm selling sweets. Then I will start. Am I talking to somebody?
Amen.
I know my husband is educated. He finished his schools, he finished his university, and he studied, and he do his drama. And me with my grade 10, I went in, and then... Men, they don't look for women that can speak English. The men, they look for women that can respect them and be a wife in their
house.
So if you are not that type, don't force yourself, don't stress yourself, don't worry. English does not make a woman. Woman makes English. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we enter in our rooms, you don't look for English, you look for a mama, you look for a wife. Am I talking to somebody? Yes! We want you people to marry a man that can speak English also here. No, mama, if we speak different language, when we are quarreling, it's not nice because you are looking for...
Hallelujah!
Every barrier in your way, everything that is making you not enjoy your life, today in the mighty name of Jesus, it will be cast down.
Amen.
Yes. Me, I have given birth to kids that is even correcting my English, but it don't disturb me.
Asiame kwa hamburga wana ohena wakuronga ngeru ingilisa nye kapai zona kuisange.
The first two, they did not do that.
Siwokuho wawawa alika pewa ngawai rugana.
Robert and Magena, they did not do that because that
Robert
time,
na Magena kam ngawai nengi.
That time I was not on the... yeah.
Asimola pena osimbe kapewa karapu.
Back from Kingsley.
It's
not this, mama, it's
this. Now
God has given us the anointed one in the house with English.
What did I
say? I'm your mother, you are not my father, man. Please stop to correct me. You understand what I'm saying, Mus? Alex can correct every second word that I'm saying.
Alex,
there's Papa sitting there. He can correct every word that I'm saying. Other day I said, Alex, my baby boy, so I'm not your baby boy, I'm my father's son. I said, Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I have decided in my mind and make up. That nothing can stop me. It's only a timing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
For me not to cook, it will not stop me not to be in the kitchen. Yes. I'm telling you. I'm a woman. I have more important things than English. Am I talking to somebody? There are things that I can learn in the way and we are learning. And if you listen to one of these things, it can bring you to fail in everything that you are studying. Mama, this brother is proposing me, but he's just speaking a nice English. And me, I'm ashamed because my sister, if you need to know, just say, yes, I love you. Yes, I love. Every time he's talking.
Asinane kwere kwa kuhangenyo kumandi kuyunga ruingisa rorua ameka pinaidi ya ruingisa asipura tupimpiringa kwa diwa tupuasi
hii na kuhara. During the process of proposal, don't talk too much if you don't know English. Don't talk too much.
Mwanzira zokuli heha seka puatia ruingisa wa uyunga unene.
Use your own strategy.
Rukane sanzira zanyamoge.
Yes, I love you. I don't like it. Yes. Okay. No, it's fine. Yes. Am I talking to somebody?
Amen.
Don't open your dictionary.
What about the dictionaries, okay?
Okay. See you. Okay. Good night. Good morning. Those are easy things.
Asoba nonkango de ure ruido no organisa delike.
If you don't have power, use here.
Asiseka wakana nonkondo organisa ruiwoge.
And then you remove the what?
The
roadblock. Are you seeing how the road is?
Asitoma nonzira mza zere kuba tundirire.
Don't walk like this. I'll come and deal with you. I'll come back tomorrow. When you come tomorrow.
Oh,
what is this one again? What is this one again? Clear them away. Remove them from your way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And get ready with your road. When you are ready to do whatever you want to do, you know you have removed the gossipers. You have removed the spirit of failure. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tate Hafeni went to our farm.
Year,
close to end of last year. This man just turned up quickly. People don't make a mistake and say Chinese they know thing, although they
know.
People are gifted here in this rundu. When you enter in the kitchen, he put the kitchen board, you will ask yourself, which company from the United States of America came and put your wardrobes and the... I'm telling you.
Asi apa no huiliramo mumasuga gogeto ya lipura skampani zoko kupiza ya turamonye ikopa.
For some of you that is putting things we've had bought in your houses.
Asi kwa wama maktura ininke no ipirangi mumambogeni.
Just call him.
What papa rentupo tatu.
After a long time he did not work, he went to our farm last year and did something that everybody that is going there they want.
Asi apa wazire kufara mazetu kwa karugana ko ininke eyawa kahara nkenye.
Hallelujah. And when he came back from the farm, I did not see Hafeni in the church. I asked Papa, but I told Papa, please slaughter for him a chicken. Chicken is his first time. How did you treat him that from the farm he ran away from the church again? Hafeni is not coming. First Sunday. Second Sunday. None of the mosquitoes maybe bite him too much at the farm. One day Baba called Hafeni. Where are you, Uncle Hafeni? Hafeni said, Baba, since I came from your farm. Blessings over blessings. Blessings over blessings. Blessings over blessings. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of you to remove the roadblocks. come close to the anointing.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Am I talking?
Amen.
Am I talking?
Amen.
If your life has become dry, remove the roadblock and come and sit next to the man of God. Have anyone went and work a big thing, big thing, big thing? And then Baba asked him, have any, how much can I pay you? Have any said, no, but Baba is not neat.
I have.
Just give me something small for
you.
I said, aye. That thing that the man did, if it was some of you, you could ask us 25,000. You here. You
are
our children here in the church. Just to come and close the window. I'm done, Mama, but the labor is
250.
You must know how to remove the roadblocks with wisdom. When you are doing things for your spiritual parents, when you are doing things for church, don't ask for payment. You are closing your own doors. Am I talking to you? When you are sweeping for the church, don't ask for payment. You are doing it for God. When you go and paint your father's house, don't ask for money. This is your reasonable service to save the man of God. Unless he is blessing you. Am I talking to somebody?
Amen.
Today, in the name of Jesus, we have removed all the roadblocks. And now, there is a race that you must run. And I declare you in the name of Jesus, for you to run freely without any roadblocks in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray over your life right now. Wherever you are, let us agree. Stand up, let us agree in the name of Jesus. You know the roadblocks in your life. You know what is that one that makes you to struggle? Pray, clap your hands and pray. Remove that roadblock in the name of Jesus. Remove that roadblock in your life in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every roadblock for disappointment, every roadblock for miscarriage, right now in the name of Jesus. As we are praying in the mighty name of Jesus, get out of your way. Every roadblock must move out of your way so that you can serve God. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray against every roadblock. Roadblock for disappointment. Roadblock for failure. In your life, in your marriage, in your family, in the life of your children. Right now, pray everybody, pray. Cancel that roadblocks. Remove them from your way. Wherever you are watching me right now, in the name of Jesus, I pray over your roadblocks to clean the way for you, to run the race that God has called you to run. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you today. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Keep on praying. Every roadblock.